Good to be back.
What is up, guys? It is Dylan Laporte back to you with another video, and today we are showing you the Destiny 2 Faction Rally event. And so the Faction Rally begins today on the 26th of September, and this is great. The factions are back. We are filling in the blank spaces in the tower, and we're finally building a bigger community and more diverse community, especially with these different factions. And now the factions for the obviously are the same from the original Destiny, but the factions are as listed: Dead Orbit, Future Warcaught, and the New Monarchy. We'll return to the tower to ask you to pledge your loyalty. Before you can make this choice, you must first reach level 20 and gain access to the tower. You will be able to pledge to one faction per character. Once you have chosen your side, your mission will be to return to the wild and complete activities in support of your faction. You can do public events, explore lost sectors, complete strikes, clear the raid, or compete in the Crucible. As you complete these activities, you will be rewarded with faction tokens that you turn in for packages full of loot. And now we're going to show you a couple of we're going to show you the New Monarchy version of me playing as my Titan. We're going to go do New Monarchy, and we're going to go through all the factions so you guys can see what you're getting into and what the Titan specifically looks like, because I usually main Titans, and sorry for you Warlocks and Hunters out there. In this video, we'll be only showing the Titan costumes, but we'll be showing you how to do stuff and how to complete the stuff and what to expect when doing this type of stuff, because you won't be, it's not that great of rewards as far as right now, but definitely the tokens will build up, and they do build up. So let's continue on with the video.
Long as the Traveler hangs above us, creatures hungry for its light will find us. This place is but a temporary refuge. Earth is dying. If humanity is to survive the dangers to come, we must leave this broken shell behind. Our future lies among the stars. Come with us, Guardian. Support Dead Orbit. Help us impress the Consensus. Refit our ships and save us all.
Alright, guys, so that was just the Dead Orbit we were talking to for a second there, and this is what the Titan gear looks like. It looks pretty cool. It kind of reminds me of a tank, kind of. I really like the helmet on it. I just really like the helmet, and the scout rifle doesn't look half bad. And I'm pretty sure that is a scout rifle. Yeah, the Haunted Earth doesn't look that bad. There's been worse scout rifles, but it has high caliber rounds on it, which is always a plus for me. But if you're looking for more like rusted southern-ish type guns and darker clothing, the Dead Orbit would be for you. So as we make our way towards this Future Warcaught, there's this glitch that's freaking weird. You can see the outside of the tower and behind the wall, essentially, and you see floating objects and people floating all over the place, and it's freaking weird. But let's go into the Men in Black studio, or the surgical procedure studio, and talk to these weird freaking Future Warcaught people. Man, look, what are the heck are they doing? Oh my god. All right, let's talk to the new her. All right.
Future Warcaught predicted the Red War. No one believed. They laughed at us. They called me a zealot, a fool. But when the attack came, we were ready. We saved thousands. War is a constant. We know this. The question is, do we wait for it to find us? Or do we study war and its timelines, identify the most likely course of events, and take the fight to our enemies? You know the answer, Guardian.
Now let's take a look at the guns. So this is the Heart of Time. It's pretty okay. Again, I just gotta get my hands on it to really know how well it is, because it has a tactical, and it's more, I'm assuming it's more of a tactical, but the stats aren't really impressing me. But let's take a look at the full set of armor, actually. It kind of looks more, I don't know, it kind of looks more shiny, and I don't know if I really like the shapes on it, but it is the known Future Warcott colors, the blue, the red, and the yellow is what the Future Warcott, but I wanted to see what this helmet looks like. This helmet, I like the side piece on the helmet, but I'm not sure if it goes with other costumes. It's Halloween. Halloween's coming around, right, guys? But I don't know. Tell me what you guys think about the Future Warcott gear. We'll get back to this thing on the wall in just a jiffy. As we make our way down to the New Monarchy, leaving Hawthorne, it looks pretty popular down here. I really like the area design of this area. Now there's just people populating it. But let's take a look inside and listen to the guy.
New Monarchy believes a strong Earth is essential for a strong humanity. We will survive. Together. And we will not surrender our home to anyone. We mobilized more rescue and relief efforts during the Red War than the other factions combined. With your support, we could do even more. What do you say?
I say, let's join it! So we're going to pledge our allegiance to New Monarchy, but first we gotta take a look at this. This actually looks kinda sweet. I'm not really digging the shader here, but the helmet does look pretty cool, and I do like the Titan mark, and I actually got the Titan mark from a package that he gave me, and I wanted to see what this one looks like. I never really saw a Titan mark that really looks like that, at least I haven't gotten one, but we're gonna pledge our allegiance to it and hopefully get some good gear.
All yours, friend.
As we spawn into EDZ, we are next to Devran, so I'd recommend going to Devran if you wanted to do the EDZ-specific dead zones, because there's three dead sectors in this area, and you can just hop to each one after you do the other one, or you can just do two and just hop between them, and actually the stuff will keep respawning. You won't get the loot again, so they can prevent farming, but you can literally, like, I guess you can say farm for the reputation tokens that they give you. So as you kill enemies and stuff, you'll see little nodes around the area that you didn't really see before. You gotta shoot these things or collect them or whatever. I don't know the extent of all the activities yet, but what you do is you go around collecting all these, and then you go back, and he doesn't give you reward, it just gives you in the game, but you go back to him, and you go and turn in your tokens, and you'll hopefully get some sweet loot out of it. But that is basically it for the video, but I did want to go over one little thing. There is this party, you need this party dance floor key thing, and I don't know exactly how to get the key, but each faction has a, like, I would say tablet where you can go and you have to turn in this key for a dance floor, and I guess there's a giant disco party. I'm not sure, but if you guys know in the comments down below, please tell me. And I'd love to figure this out and get a key for having an epic dance party, and then I'll let you guys know as soon as I have that epic dance party. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching my video. I really appreciate it. Make sure you guys check out the podcast. Follow me on Twitter at Dylan's Legos, Instagram, YouTube, WordPress. I mean, if you like reading my articles. And then again, I just released the new PlayStation, Monday Morning PlayStation podcast. So go check all that stuff out. A lot of stuff is happening since I'm in college, and hopefully I can keep up with these videos. But this is Dylan Lepore signing off. Bye.
Earn your honor, Guardian.